This facility is not open to the public. The facility is available when our customers are in town and other special guests such as yourself.
This is the mock-up cabin.
The engineering design teams did a fantastic job.
But the good thing is this is very, very straightforward sitting.
This is my love. This is Boeing 747.
All right, Sam, let's take a look at one of the mega first class suites.
Wow, what a space here. This is incredible.
One bed and one chair, which is really, really handy.
Wow. This is my love. This is Boeing 747, where my love of aviation has started on this plane, and when I come in, the feeling was very different. I became very emotional. It's bringing my childhood memories back. When I was young, when you fly intercontinental, every single airplane was a 747.
Well, welcome, Sam. I've got a VIP configuration upstairs. Let's go take a look at that.
VIP configuration, even better treat from Boeing. Let's go have a look.
So you see a very traditional kind of configuration, high pitch configuration back here. But up here, we're showing a space that's more of a premium space. Normally would hold four first class suites. We're showing with two of the suites removed and a lounge put in to be more of a VIP style configuration for airlines that may be government owned. Occasionally they borrow a commercial airplane and have a, you know, head of state use it. So we're kind of showing that art of the possible.
Yeah, I mean, this is really the head of state belongs to on the upper deck of the 747, where it's the most quiet and private cabin. Look at this, oh my gosh. No wonder the 747 is still the favorite of many, many head of states.
Very
governmental.
True.
Yeah. Wow, what a space here. This is incredible. And wish every airline has a lounge like the good old days.
All right, Sam, let's take a look at one of the mega first class suites.
Wow.
Similar to some that airlines are flying.
Yeah, I thought this is mega. Okay, let's go have a look. Oh, wow. This is actually, many people would recognize Lufthansa. They have this one bed and one chair, which is really, really handy and beautiful privacy. What I like about laying on this bed is, you know, you have complete level when you lay fully flat on the bed, and you can look out the window, really, really intimate, and you can have all your beautiful daydream out there. Really like it. Ken, I had a walk through your 747 mock-up, so impressed and love it. But I feel like, I don't know, what is wrong with me, the perspective or something? This 747 feels a lot wider than the actual 747. Is it because you're having less seats inside, more space, or
no,
what
it
is?
It's a great question, and everybody thinks that. And it really goes to the research and design that went into our interiors and our interior philosophy. We're actually using lighting, the bins, all the surfaces designed to work together. So psychologically, it feels like the space is bigger than what it actually is. And that's a key component, because we as humans perceive space in multiple ways. Some as physical, some as psychological, visual, and we're using our knowledge and research-based data to actually build into our design process.
It's so to me. Now, you're a psychologist, by the way.
I do have a degree in psychology, yes.
There you go. This is my favorite section, because why? If you sit in the first row, think about it, the cockpit is upper deck, but the first row of the nose is actually in front. You're sitting actually in the very front end of the plane before even the cockpit, before even the pilot seat. So the 747 have an amazing curvature that and expand your view if you're sitting in front at the nose. Thank you.
you have three different configuration here. This is more like a premium economy, like a 2, 3, and 2. The next one we have is the 2, 4, and 2 sitting abreast, 8 seats across, which is, it gives you, can you see that little extra width here? There's only 2 carriers, as far as I know, have the 2, 4, and 2 original configuration devised by Boeing, which is ANA, All Nippon, and JAL, Japan Airlines. Now follow me to the economy class. So this is the more conventional 787 configuration, and this is 3, 3, 3 across the economy. This is back in business class, and the 787 is very wide enough. You can have 2, 2, 2. This is Zodiac Aerospace. This is the manufacturer of the seat, and it's very wide, and I like the straightforwardness because you face straight, you don't face diagonal or whatsoever. And however, there is pros and cons in each type of seats of design. Really, there's real estate on the airplane is important. And this seat here, if you are sitting inside as my neighbor, you would have to hop across me to get out to the bathroom or to walk off somewhere. And but the good thing is this is very, very straightforward sitting and very wide as well. So you'll probably recognize some of the seats here on the 78. It's like a 1, 2, and 1. They're called a reverse herringbone, which is actually the diagonal facing business class. So it is really nice if you're sitting in the solo seats here looking out the window, because you're kind of, your eyesight facing diagonally out to the window. The only thing I didn't like is it's not forward facing. So when you sleep, when you recline, you actually sleep sideways. I'm going to show you. Not going straight and you're going sideways like this.
This is the 737 Sky Interior Max Interior. When we, you know, had this philosophy and it was used to inform the 787, we saw how powerful it was. We thought, how do we apply this, these philosophical goals to the 737? Because 737, super popular, super efficient, super reliable. We wanted to say, if we can improve the passenger experience, let's do that. So what you're seeing here is the application of this same philosophy to the 737. Primary challenges were, it's an existing airplane. How do we apply this without adding weight, without changing structure, and without affecting factory flow? So it was a big challenge for us. But the engineering design teams did a fantastic job. So you'll see, probably the most noticeable are the pivot bins. You can push on the top and the bin opens. You can push on the bottom, bin opens. Pull on the top, pull on the bottom, whatever's intuitive to the passenger, it opens. The shelf is always there, even when the bin is closed, right?
Yep.
When you're seated, you're always looking at that shelf. It really closes the cabin down. But the benefit is, when they're closed, which is the majority of flight, here I'm almost 6 foot tall, I can step out of the aisle and still stand. Seated, I'm no longer looking at a shelf. It opens up the ceiling, it opens up the cabin, makes it much more spacious, creating this sense of spaciousness, physical space, and a sense of spaciousness. So it's both physical and psychological. Our interiors are not a collection of features. Literally, these are by design based in research. Everything is done with intent to create that sense of physical and psychological space. We call this one Desert Sunset. And then along the horizon, you get this beautiful orange glow as the sun's setting.